black president be having a press conference, you know, reporter just jump up, excuse me, tell us about Monica Lewinsky. What? Hold on, dog. What you gonna ask me in front of my wife and everything, dog? They trying to get Clinton now, ain't he? Man, the only person gonna be able to get him off is Johnny Cochran. I was trying to imagine that phone call, man. He got to call Johnny Cochran up. Cochran be at home, sleep. Phone ring, groom. Hello? This is Mr. Big. How you doing, Mr. Big? What the hell is going on? What you mean, what's going on? Oh, man. That's the kind of songs that's out, too, right now. Them I love ghetto love songs. Y'all like them? That's all we got. We don't have no real deep love songs no more. A lot of ghetto love songs. Songs just mean a lot in the ghetto. 'Cause I'm your baby daddy. Girl, you can page me anytime. 'Cause I'm your baby. Is somebody sitting at home with Ricky Lake on to me? Ooh, that's my jam. Ooh, I just love that song. It's a trip though, man. I don't have no real good songs no more, man. That's why I like this little group, LSG. Y'all like them? Levert, Sweat, and Gil. I like them because they remind me of the old school. You know, and they sing too, but in a way. Don't they all sound like different animals and insects when you think about it? I mean, Gerald LaVert sound like a grizzly bear, you know. Keith Sweat sound like a damn mosquito in your ear. My pretty boy. Johnny Gill smooth, and then he just turned into a Rottweiler on your ass. What's all that barking and growling he get to doing at the end of the song? He started out smooth. Yeah. Got me singing my. Get your dog, man. Ain't nobody scared. Get your dog. That's just the kind of singers we got out now. Them the kind of songs. Nobody's singing songs of passion anymore. Nobody doing beautiful songs like old school, like OJs, like had songs supposed to touch you, you know, make you feel something on the inside. Like the OJ's Family Reunion. Remember that song, Family Reunion? It's so nice to see all the family. You sitting there crying, think about Big Mama. Big Mama. No, you called your grandma my dear. Trip is, though, they don't have songs like that. Like opera. You ever trip off like opera? You gotta trip off that because you don't even understand what they talking about. But you know the song has a lot of passion and meaning. You can just look at their face and tell they singing about something. You don't know what the hell it is, but you care. You know what I'm saying? You know, just come on, you see it in their face. And it's all in the face. Check out the faces.
Qui dove il mare luccica e tira forte il vento, su una vecchia terrazza davanti al golfo di Surriere, un uomo abbraccia una ragazza dopo che aveva pianto. Poi si schiarisce la voce e ricomincia il canto. Te voglio bene assai, ma tanto, tanto bene.
Come on, don't tell me I ain't want to cry just then. You ain't know what I was singing about. You was like, ooh, say it, go on, say it. It's a trip, man. See, we got songs, though, that come out, like, that don't really have, like, a lot of meaning, but, you know, we care about them. Like women get a woman's issue song every year. Woman's right. Man ain't treating us right. Every year, y'all get one of them songs. Ever since Ain't Nothing Going On But The Rent. That's what started it. This year, it was Tyrone. You know, brother need to call Tyrone. I don't even know Tyrone that good. And I like the song. I like the song until she get all sassy. You know, that's what make me mad. You know, the song nice till she, you know, she's singing, you know. Tell him, come on, help you pack your shit. What? I wish a motherfucker would tell me I gotta go some damn well. I paid the cable. Well, I ain't gotta go nowhere till the end of the month then, shit. Tyrone don't have to be over here till the 30th, shit. I ain't going no damn well. See, last year it almost got messed up with y'all though, because they gave the woman anthem song to Mary J. Blige. And she almost blew it. You know, because Mary, well, everybody know, Mary, she don't speak real well. I'm just saying, she don't say all the words real, real good. You know, and I'm not talking about Mary in particular, because, you know, we all know somebody. Everybody in here know people. You know, that might say Amber Lamps. Or down the street. I want some jumbo scrimps. Or my throat is hurting, I have a sore throat. That's not what I'm talking about. What I'm saying is Mary is all on the record, and music is universal. You don't need people trying to figure out what the hell you talking about. And she's singing, can't say the word real good, but it's her part. She into it, you know. I was your lover and your secretary, working every day of the... What the hell is a secretary? Say office assistant or something like that if you can't say the damn word. Don't do that to people. Don't have folks trying to figure that out. Chilling, man, out in L.A., doing the Steve Harvey Show. Y'all watch the Steve Harvey Show? Cool. Me and my man, we have a lot of fun doing that show. It's exciting. We have a lot of fun, but I'm in Los Angeles. You know, I got to be in L.A. to do it. You know, I'm from St. Louis, Midwest. It's a little different in Los Angeles because there's a lot of little fruity cocoa pebbles out there, you know. You know, I ain't trying to talk about people's lifestyle, but the gay issue and got too big for me. It took on a whole nother vibe. You know, they had like a parade out there 2 weeks ago. They was marching. It was issues going on. People was marching trying to have gay day. They wanted gay day off. You know what I'm saying? Gay day, like Martin Luther King Day, like any other day you get off, they wanted gay day. And that's okay, because, you know, black people, we usually take any damn day off. That's fine with us, but, you know, that's a hard one to explain right there, though, ain't it? Boy, you show up at work the next day, you took off, all your partners looking at you. Why was you off yesterday, dog? I was sick. You wasn't sick. Yesterday was gay day, man. Your ass is gay. Ain't nobody gay. They serious about it, though. They got scientists now trying to prove it's a gay gene in the body that make people gay. You believe that one, dog? Gay gene make you gay. Ain't no damn gay gene, is it, please? I'm saying if you gay, you know, be gay. Handle your business. Don't be acting like I could have caught it. That's all I'm saying. You know, like the shit, the flu or something, you know. I've been living straight all my life. Somebody sneeze, I wake up the next morning talking about, woo! Ooh, I am feeling too lavender today, honey. I am telling you. Ain't no damn gay gene. Because if it was a gay gene, you got to think about this logically now. If it was a gay gene, that means God put the gay gene in everything that reproduce sexually like humans. Therefore, you'll have gay dogs. See that? Gay cats. Gay birds. Somewhere on the farm, it's a big ass gay cow. You know, just out on the farm. Moo! 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 Heifer! Say it ain't so, dog. Come on, help me out on that one, y'all. It ain't so, dog. Man. A trip like that too, though, man. That's what's going on in the world, though. All kinds of issues like that. You know, the whole gay thing. And then all the little kids that was like shooting each other a couple of months ago. Little kids going to school, taking the steel to school. Man, that's sad. Little kids taking the steel to school, guns. You know, I was thinking about that because we used to take the steel to school. We did. We used to take it to school, but it wasn't a gun. It was a lunchbox. That was a lethal weapon when you think about it. I'll whoop somebody's ass with a Starskin Hutch lunchbox, nigga. Go on, Harold. $6 million man lunchbox, nigga. That's for that dude that play too much. It's always one dude in every neighborhood that play too damn much, ain't it? You gotta fight him. I mean, look, you know what I'm saying? It's always that one dude that's overzealous. Everybody outside playing touch football. Everybody playing touch football. Here come Big June ass. Knock you all into a car or something, man. Damn, Big June. Play too much. That's why don't nobody be playing with you. We got stars that play too much too. Like Mike Tyson. Gonna bite that boy on his ear like that. Come on now. That's too much damn playing right there. Ain't put no hot sauce on it or nothing. I knew Mike Tyson wasn't gonna beat Holyfield though. They was like, you know, they put too much on it, on the whole promotions, you know. It was one of them things where you have to decide. Like first I was with Mike Tyson because, you know, they was like, Mike Tyson, baddest fighter ever, you know, and Holyfield, you know, he nice guy. So I'm thinking, okay, you got a hoodlum and a nice guy. Let me go with the hoodlum. I'm gonna go over here. And then they kept promoting, you know, Mike Tyson got the criminal record. Holyfield, once again, good guy. So a thug gets good guy. Okay, I'm gonna go with the thug. All right, I know a couple of thugs, I'm gonna roll with them. Then they got all into their religion. This when it got a little shaky, you see, because Mike Tyson is Muslim, Holyfield Christian. Uh-oh. Hold on. Now what, then we just start going Muslim, what, 62, 63? Been with the Lord a long time. Look here, let me get 25 on Jesus. I'm gonna have to go with the undisputed savior on this one then. I'm gonna have to. You see, I won. You see, I won. It's a trip, man. I've been watching a lot of television, though. They got a lot of televangelists on now. You know, faith healers that heal people. Y'all believe in them, folks? Brothers and sisters, how are you? I heard you were hungry. Heal right there. Go outside and get you something to eat. I got you. They had some faith healers on from Detroit, some of them players. Y'all see them? They got on purple suits, finger waves, rim up there, cool as hell. He all like this. What's up, man? Go ahead. What, you hungry? All right, hold on. Abba Dabba Super Saber David Day. There you go. Go on ahead. Get you something to eat. It's a trip, though, man. I like that because I ain't been to church in a while. And I went on Mother's Day, you know, and that's a hard thing when you ain't been to church and, you know, you just haven't been. I'm going to tell the truth. I hadn't been, going. And I went on Mother's Day and, well, I was a visitor. That's scary when you a visitor, you know, because you ain't been in a while. That means that at some point in time, you might have to stand up and have words. That's scary, you know what I'm saying, because all I knew was hip-hop language. I ain't been in a while. I'm standing up in the middle of the church talking about, first of all, giving big ups to God. Rem, you bout it. And the choir, whoo. My mama in the choir stands with, sit your ass down. Church a trip, because you know a lot of times you promise you're going to go and then you don't go. Don't you say, man, I'm going to get on up, go on in. You don't even make it, do you? You go, this is the Sunday right here. I'm going to iron my clothes on Saturday. That way I can hop right on up, go on in. You don't even make it, do you? When you finally do go, it be Easter like everybody else. Well, you come walking, you see some people be at church on Easter, ain't been to church in so long. They don't even know what to do. Nigga, they all up in the pulpit. Hey, player, these two seats taken right here. Oh, them somebody seats, all right. Oh, you finally make it in this second Sunday. Y'all know what second Sunday is? Old folk choir. Now keep it real with me, I'm gonna keep it real with you. Don't nobody really wanna be there on old folk choir, do they? You have finally got up to go in and you on your way in and you hear them singing and you be like, golly, nigga. Damn, it's old folk choir. Because you want to hear like the jam, like Going Up Yonder or something like that. And they be in there hitting them hymns. Them long, drawn out. We're marching to Zion. Brood of a Zion. We're marching on to Zion. Brood of a city. You be in there trying to stay up. Hey, let me get a peppermint or something from you, man. Sometimes they'll fool you, though, you know, because black churches, we creative people. We'll take a song off the radio, secular song, and make it a church song. Just add a few old lords, have mercy Jesus, church song right there. And I went in this church a couple of weeks ago, second Sunday, old folk choir. They was coming on in, they had their little robes on. They were coming on in. It was Sister Johnson and Sister Wilhelmina Green. Sister Green wig on crooked, it ain't on straight. Had their little robes on, they was coming on in. And they was singing Shoop. Whitney Houston, Shoop. They was working it out. Sister Green, right up front. Everyone fall in love sometime. Don't know the words, making up shit. You think I'm wrong. Well, I think I'm fine. Singing shoo, 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 shoo-be-doo, my Lord. Sometimes you laugh. That ain't right, is it? Ooh, my mama can't stand that joke. I just be falling behind her in the kitchen. Shoo, shoo. Whoa, shoo. That tickles me. It's a trip, man. I've been watching a lot of golf these days, man. A lot more golf. You know what I'm saying? Just because Tiger Woods won a couple, a year ago, I won, watch more golf. I like about that. I like golf now, It's an interesting sport when you think about it. But, you got more black people playing golf, watching golf now. And the people who play golf know the post-Tiger days. They know when black people be out at the golf course. We totally different out there. We walking all across the grass. Nigga barbecuing. Out there trying to borrow people golf cart to run to the stove. Nigga, I'll be back. Ain't like it's your cart. We just don't understand, that's all. It's a trip too, man. Cause now, that opened it up for us. We start doing more sports like that. You see us, you'll start seeing us. Black people downhill skiing. You know what I'm saying? Water polo, synchronized swimming, hockey. I don't know about hockey, dog. I don't know, they got a couple of bros playing, but I don't know if they gonna let some real bros play hockey, dog. Hockey? And you get to fight too? They actually let you fight. Oh, it'd be a brother out there skating without a stick, nigga, just. Oh, you know what he thinking. I wish a motherfucker would come over here. That's my kind of logic right there, man. Makes sense to me. That's why I like Ebonics. I couldn't even believe black people was getting all upset about Ebonics. Hey, calm down. Let Ebonics be a language. Let it happen. If Ebonics is a language, that means we can start whooping their ass at Scrabble. Trip off what I'm saying to you. Now, we got words they can't pronounce, let alone spell. Libeler. I'm liable to bust your head if you don't get my damn points. Come on now. If libeler is a word, then, That's it. My baby daddy. My baby daddy. One damn word. Come on, get my points, dog. Get my points, man. Put me on Wheel of Fortune now. Put me on Wheel of Fortune now. Black people be on Wheel of Fortune asking for weird letter combinations. Let me get a L-E. The phrase is lemme. Lemme $20 to tomorrow. Nigga, I got you. I'm going to give your little paper back, dog. It's a trip, man. Just sitting over there listening to the little music industry, too. That's some wild thing now, It's calmed down, especially the rap game, Rap music calmed down a lot, though. It was pretty bad a couple of years ago, like when Biggie and Tupac got shot. It was bad. Everybody was rapping about death. Tupac manifested his death. He rapped about death every three records. Every four songs, Tupac, if I die tonight, I'll be dead. So homie, don't page me. because I'm already dead. I was like, damn, Tupac. I was wondering why they rap about death like that, though. You know, rappers, they always consume that they're gonna die and death is around them and I die. Hey, live is better. I don't know, but I understand they rapping from a reality, you know, in which they live, you know. A lot of things ain't all fun and games. Life ain't hunky-dory. I understand that. I got problems, issues. Stuff make me want to die sometime. I got little things go wrong, make me feel like dying. Little stuff, though, you know, stuff everybody go through. You know, like get up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom, stub your damn toe on the end of the bed. Come on now. Can't tell me that pain right there don't make you want to lay down and call him up. Come on, Father, let's go. Woo, Jesus, I can't take it no more. Come get me. Calgon, somebody come get me. I got to go. I can't do it. You sitting up in the morning, we making you some bacon and eggs, and that damn bacon grease jump up and fry you on your hand. Come on. Come on now, you can't tell me that pain right there don't make your ass want to be dead right there now. Come on. I mean, that's the stuff I go through, dog. I mean, little things. I don't know if y'all really feeling me, though. See, I don't think y'all understand it how I... DJ, kick my music, man. Today.
Y'all don't feel me. I'm in so much pain. Y'all don't know what I go through, y'all. Look here. When I woke up this morning, I was hungry. So I went to the kitchen to get some cereal. To be specific, some Honey Nut Cheerios. When I poured them in the bowl and realized it wasn't no milk, nigga, I thought I was gonna die. Thought I was gonna die. The other day I was late for work, so I hopped in the shower, but turned on the wrong knob. The water was hot, it backed me in the corner, nigga, I thought I was gonna die. Daughter's gonna die. Daughter's gonna die, y'all. Daughter might die. It was the summer of 93, and I'm chilling in the park with some Maury Gator sandals on. I know they cold, cause everybody jocking them. Feel me? But then this dude let his dog go, and everybody started running. But my sandals had me slipping, nigga. I thought I was gonna die. I thought I was gonna die. Thought I might die, y'all. Thought I was gonna die. Thought I might die, y'all. Around the time that I was 12 years old, I had a huffy with a banana seat and scissor pole. The ace of spades in the smoke to make that noise. I'm popping willies, showing off for the girls and boys. But then I slipped off my seat and hit that middle pole. Oh, I thought I was gonna die. Atlantic City, said the entertainer, baby. Ahala.
Give it up for Cedric the Entertainer. You having fun? Alright, more people that came in. Good. Welcome, welcome. You just sit next to a white person, say welcome. This is Hug a White Person Day today. Hug your local white person. Hug him. Hug him, man. You hug him. Hug him. Hug him, man. My man with the dreadlock. Hug him. Come on, man. You like a nappy palm tree. Go ahead and hug that. Right here. Turn around and shake their hand. Shake their hand. Say, welcome. Thank you for coming. It's like church. You know you're doing the church. The visitors, they visitors. Give it up for my hometown, St. Louis, Missouri, Mr. Cedric the Entertainer, y'all. All right, we got a little something we're going to do right now. I got one quick announcement that I'm going to make real quick. On October 30th, there's a movie coming out called American History X, which I'm in. I please want you to go out and support it. It's a very, very, very good movie. Go out and support it. And you know, first weekend, that's when it counts. First weekend, support the movie, October 30th, American History X. All right? Y'all going to go? What's up, Sean? Mr. Sean from Boys and Men, y'all right here. What's up, man? What's up, Sharonda? Hanging out. What you doing hanging out in Jersey, man? You live here? Oh, hi. I like that chain, man. Where you park your car, man? I got a ski mask in the back. Thanks for coming, man. National recording artist. Good seeing you, man. Always, man. You owe me $5, too. Remember that? What my $5, nigga? Got them platinum singing for the Pope, and you can't give me my damn $5. How black people are? See how black people are? All right, y'all, what we're going to do right now, we're going to take a 15-minute intermission. That'll give you a chance to go out, get your drinks, go to the bathroom, get the drawers out your little booty, see who cheating on who, and see who wearing the same outfit you got on, all right? So 15 minutes, be right back here for the second half of the Kings of Comedy, y'all.
No, I'm happy. That's a beautiful goddamn thing. Wife, you know you made it. Thank you, Lord. You know you successful when white people come see your ass. I'm going to see Byrne. It's a new guy called fucking Bernie Mac. I'm going to see the guy. Black folk, we just go see any motherfucker, you know. I'm going to see somebody. Look, come on in. Ain't that a bitch? Just got through giving white people props and the brothers had to come fuck it up. Come in late, the show started at 7 goddamn o'clock. White people here got their programs. They finished reading the shit. You come in, your beeper going off. Your woman, hey, how you doing, Tweety? Is that a dog or what the fuck? Oh. No, I didn't know it's dog out here. The fuck I know? I love you, Tweety. I thought you had a poodle or something. I didn't know the fuck what type of shit it did. I'm here to have a good goddamn time. You got white people here, black people, Asian. That's the way it's supposed to be. Mixed. We beepers. Tired of racism. Tired of black and white. That's all the fuck I hear. Black and white. Black men, white men. The white men, the black men. If I was Chinese, I'd be mad at the motherfucker. They don't never say shit about us. Never say shit. But we sure quick to laugh at their ass at the Chinese restaurant. Eh? Let me have number 14, 15. When they start talking that nom, nom, bing, nom, bite, die, you start kicking on the table, kicking and shit. Keep laughing at motherfuckers who fix your food for you. See what the fuck happened to you. Oh, Chinese, come back and feed your ass some cat or dog and shit. You be barking all fucking night. Man, you don't fuck with your stomach. Your stomach is the most delicate thing on your goddamn body. That and the ass. When your stomach fucked up, you ain't in no shape to do shit. And you can tell when your stomach fucked up what you gotta do. When you fart, your fart will tell you what you gotta do. If you get a fart that go, your stomach just hurt. That's all that is. That ain't nothing but some gas. If you get a fart that go, you got a shit. When you hear that, your ass is wet. Soggy than a motherfucker. Ain't nothing worse than a wet ass, let me tell you. I'm telling you like it is. See men, we pass gas, you know. We can't do the shit in front of people though. You gonna do that shit in front of your boys. Women can't pass no gas at all. Oh, women pass gas, you'll cuss they fucking ass out. Especially on the first date. Hey baby, you having a good time? Nasty bitch. Stinking ass bitch. What happened to that girl? I ain't gonna see that skunk motherfucker no more, man. Bitch farted all in my car and shit. What type of shit is this? I don't care how fine she is. She farting in your car, you mad. And she ain't tell you? That's the worst thing somebody can do is fart, don't tell you. And you getting ready to talk. Man, stinking bastard! You know I ain't lying. We all the same. I'm gonna tell like it is. Ain't no different with nobody. Ain't no difference between black, white, tweet, marching, doing that old bullshit. We the same fucking people. Everybody here gonna die. Whites do the same fucking shit we do, they just do the shit different. Whites pay their bills on fucking time. Black folks, we pay our bills when the fuck we get ready. You see the bills on the goddamn table. Black folks, we'll push that shit to the side. We don't pay no bills, we see some red writing inside that envelope. And every black person in here know what the fuck red mean. Red mean hurry up! Be quick, motherfucker, be fast! And we know black folks like to argue. No, we ain't paid no bills. The light cut off, but that still don't stop your ass from going out there to argue with that lady behind that counter. Bitch, what the fuck I'm gonna do now? Come around that motherfucker! You know you ain't paid shit. Now you wanna make a payment plan agreement. Let me put $20 down there. What the fuck $20 gonna do? The bill $900. You lazy bastard. Look out for a motherfucker. You know I ain't lying. White folks the same type of people that we are. We just do shit different. Black folks, we the only people that go to our job and swear we run that motherfucker. I know white folks talk about us like a dog when they get home. I'm so fucking tired of these Negroes, I swear. Because you say the shit your goddamn self when you get to the crib. These brothers make me sick like a motherfucker. Don't let them go on break. Shit. White people go on break, you can find them. They sit at their desk and eat their sandwich and drink their fucking tea. When we go on break, that's just what the fuck we do. You gotta look for those some bitches. And don't let it be no telephone on the job. Or we gonna call everybody, but who the hell we supposed to call? If our job is talking on the telephone, recruit, we gonna call all our whole goddamn family. And get mad when they tell us to get off the goddamn phone. You wait on your supervisor outside. And we always talking about, say, man, you know, black people violent people. No, we ain't. Black people some loving people. We just talk a lot of shit. We ain't gonna cut nobody up. We'll blow your head off. And cuss you out while we're doing it. Pow! Nah, motherfucker. Wife will chop your ass off. Hold his leg, Joe! Hold his leg! We ain't gonna watch nobody get stabbed no 30-something time. We can't handle it. You killing after the second stab. You killing that motherfucker, man. You killing him. When you hear white people, when you hear brothers talk shit, don't pay them no attention. That's all the fuck they doing. I blow this motherfucker up. We ain't gonna blow up shit. First of all, who gonna save the dynamite? Soon you go purchase some dynamite, you're going to jail. I wanna buy 4 blocks of dynamite. Your dumb ass going to jail. Now we'll tell you we're gonna blow some shit up. Especially like if we come to pick up our check and you ain't got our check. Then we'll procrastinate that we're gonna blow the, I'm here to pick up my check. What you looking for? My check ain't here. Are you looking for it? I look for that motherfucker, look for it. Oh, you found it? Shit, I'm finna say. I'll blow this motherfucker up. We ain't gonna blow up shit. That's all it is. People just do shit different. Same shit. People argue, fuss, kids, whole nine yards. They say black people cuss too much. That's bullshit. White people can do some cussing too now. Can't nobody say cocksucker like white folk. Fucking cocksucker! That an asshole, asshole! You driving on the expressway, cut him off. Fucking cocksucker! Everybody got their word. Mexican got puto. You fucking out of puto, read out of puto. Black words is motherfucker. We'll motherfucker you to death. Can't nobody say motherfucker like black people. Motherfucker. Listen how black people talk. You listen to a conversation. You hear 15 motherfuckers and one regular English word. But the sentence makes sense like a motherfucker. Man, when I see that motherfucker, man, he owe me $5 motherfucking dollars. He ain't paid me my motherfucking money yet. The motherfucker told me he gonna pay me last motherfucking Tuesday. I ain't seen the motherfucker. But when I see that motherfucker, I'm gonna bust his motherfucking head. You know I ain't lying. All that I'm trying to show you is, man, everybody can get along. We the people just keep putting emphasis on this whole crazy shit, man. Everybody say this group do that, that group do this. That's all bullshit. They say we fuck all the time. White folks fuck too. They love to fuck. They on TV more than us fucking. You see those X-rated tapes. Our taste be fuzzy as shit. They just fuck for different reasons. White folks fuck for trust funds, insurance policies. They fuck for heritage. We fuck for rent. Outfits, light bill. We got to do what we got to do. And everybody here getting older. When you get older, you're supposed to get better. You're supposed to get better. I'm telling you for a fact, I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm old. I can't fuck like I used to. I'm not interested. Sex ain't nothing but hard goddamn work, man. They ain't shipping some physical goddamn labor. Just pumping all goddamn night. Fuck you trying to achieve? Fuck till your heart stop. You know? He's a strong fucker. That's bullshit. Just 45 minutes, just fuck it, just fuck it. Chest hurting. Lips white. My back hurt right here. And she laying there with her legs up right there.
Come, ooh, right there.
What the fuck is her right there? Bust the nest so we can go to sleep. Tired of shit. I'm old.
I want to make it last.
Bitch, you don't bust this nut, I'm going to choke the fuck out of you, I'm telling you. You ain't gonna kill me. I'm tired. Just fucking clothes everywhere. Mattress twisted and shit. Pillows sprinkled every goddamn where. And she's sitting there. Phew. Listen to the words that come out of people's mouth when they make love. Listen, I be busting up because I'm stupid. I'm not well. I be making love. I be listening for all those fucked up old sounds and shit, you know. What the hell is a ha ha ha? What the fuck is I'm making love to my wife, man. I went to did my thing. All of a sudden I heard, what the fuck is some hell? Busting that. All that hollering and groaning and shit. I'm tired. I got a problem. I'm not ashamed to tell you fine people. We all grown. So I ain't putting on no ass to you. I'm saying what you're scared to say. Because you think people ain't going to like it when you tell the truth. I can't fuck no more. 3 minutes. I'm weak. I went to the doctor. I said, doctor, something wrong, man. I ain't the man I used to be. I used to be a sex champion. I used to, man, when I got on some pussy, boy, I said, fuck hell, pussy, boy. Now I'm retired. I'm retired now. My shit is on the wall of Hall of Fame. I look at it and get mad. My wife said, you gonna come on and do something? I try to find an excuse. I'm going to Cleveland. I'm going to Cleveland this week. Cause I can't fuck no more. 3 minutes. Tired. 3 minutes. That's all I'm giving her. That's all I got. My wife was playing with me in the bed the other day. We was in the bed naked. We was wrestling. I told her, hurry up. I said, you know, I ain't got long now. You up here bullshitting. You better come on now, I ain't got long. She wanna wrestle and play. Man, next thing you know, man, I came on her belly. I don't know, you know. She cussed my black ass out. I didn't give a fuck, I was asleep. I'm telling you the truth. Sex is hard work, man. All sex, all that stuff, man, come to par. It's a time, place for everything. But women love all sex. That's just the way it is. Oh, see, look at you clapping. Look at you whistling. Look at you. Look at you. Ooh, Hercules, Hercules. Women love you to do some all sex. All you got to do is say, girl, I'll kiss your ass. Watch what she tell you. When? Don't even know your name. What your name is? But women don't like to do oral sex with men. I don't understand this shit. I got a problem with that. Men been doing women for years, decades. Ain't never complained. Every time you ask a woman to do you, they get attitude. Especially black women, because you got to give clues, hints. Why don't you come over here and lay your head? Come here, lay your head. Come here and relax. Come here and relax. They'll cuss your ass out. What the fuck you mean by that? I don't understand it. But when you do, they go crazy. But see, men, we the same thing. Share life. If you that's your woman, you gotta give your woman the best you got. But if you don't, you're gonna lose her. And vice versa. Don't be shame. Don't be shame. You do it. Everybody need love. I don't care if you're a preacher. I don't care if you're a preacher. Everybody need a nut sometime. In the name of the Lord, you need it. Ain't no shame thing, but the messed up thing about that is kids. See, the world messed up. Kids. See, I'm saying what you're afraid to say, I'm telling you. Kids make me sick. I can't stand no some of my bitches. I'm not talking about the kids from the 70s and the 60s and the early 80s. I'm talking about these 90 goddamn kids here. Ooh, these some bitches, man, I can't stand them. Ever since they changed the rules, stopped us from hitting these fuckers, I lost interest in them. These some bad some of my bitches. They ain't got no respect for no damn body with they spoiled ass. See, I grew up with Big Mama. Ain't no Big Mama no more. Ain't no more grandmamas. Your grandmama now, was she 34? Great-grandmama, great-grandmama 34, grandmama 24. See, that's what I'm talking about. I got a daughter, my daughter 20 years old. My daughter is in college. The last 4 years of my life, my wife and I have been swinging real well. Nobody in the house, her and I. Now, I got 3 new kids. At 40 years of age, what the fuck I need 3 new children for? 2, 4, and 6. Yeah, ooh. This is my sister kids, you know. I ain't ashamed to tell you, my sister on drugs, you know. And the state was gonna take the kids, you know. But I came and intervened. Yeah, my sister on drugs, I said it, I ain't ashamed. Some of your family fucked up too. Yeah, y'all clapping, look at you. Come help me take care of these bastards. I'm sitting there in court, I should have did just like my brother did. My brother sat there and didn't say a damn word. He just turned his goddamn head. When they said, we're gonna get the kids to the state, he turned his head. I had to get my self-righteous ass up. No, this is not right. We're family. We gotta stick together. Had I known these bastards like this, boy, they'd be separated right now. Man, 2, 4, and 6. And that 2-year-old, she the son of a bitch. That heifer been here before, man. She an apostle for the devil, I tell you. The other day I was combing her hair, I was looking for some numbers. And the 4-year-old, my sister must have really been getting high with her. Cause she don't say shit, all she do is look at you. I told her the other day, I said, hell, if a fire break out, you better learn how to whistle or something. Cause you gonna be a burned up bitch fucking with me. I ain't got time to go to no fire looking for nobody like this here. So, she just staring at you. And the 6-year-old cried like a son bitch. The 2-year-old got the 6-year-old mind. Whatever the 6-year-old kid tell the 2-year-old tell the 6-year-old, he do it. No, he run and do it. And she kicks him, scratch him, beat him up. He cried like a little old heifer all the time. He came in my room one day crying like a little bitch. I knew what was wrong. I said, Sabrina. He said, yeah. I said, look at my drawer and get my pistol, you know. No, this heifer gotta be stopped, man. She gotta be stopped. I'm telling y'all the truth. Ladies and gentlemen, she's bad. These kids not bad. I came home the other day, man, 1 o'clock in the morning. The 2-year-old sent the 6-year-old downstairs for some milk and cookies. He gonna walk past me like I'm a visitor. I said, sir, where you going? To get some cookies. I said, sir, it's kind of late. Go on back upstairs. She wants some cookies now. I said, I don't give a fuck what she wants. You better go on upstairs before you get fucked up down here. I don't mean no harm, that's how I talk to him. Hell with that timeout shit, I ain't got time. These kids murder us. You ain't gonna murder me. I'm gonna murder them. You be reading about it on the news. He gonna go upstairs. The 2-year gonna say, where are the cookies and stuff? He gonna tell her, him downstairs. Like I ain't got no damn name or something. Who the fuck is him? She gonna tell him, I go get the shit myself. She come waltzing down in the kitchen, got a little step ladder, go open the refrigerator, I'm watching. I said, what you getting ready to do? Get some cookies. I said, didn't you hear me tell your friend you can't handle goddamn cookies? And I said, now you open that refrigerator, I'm hitting your doggone temple, I'm not bullshit. She gonna look at me, man, like I stuttered or something. She gonna look at me like I'm short. I said, get your ass upstairs. And they never gonna sleep. Just walking around the house 2-3 o'clock in the morning. See, my sister had these kids, she was on drugs. She must have been on coke and reefer. Cause they wide alert and they always hungry. My wife and I can't talk no more. I can't make decent love to my wife because the kids won't go to sleep. We got to make plans. 4 years of my life, man, I'm telling you, when you get older and your priorities change, you got to change with it. I'm old. And when you got kids, you can't do the same thing you used to. These ain't number words. Hey, I'll go, okay. But the truth is, these summer bitches make me sick. And if you touch them, now they sue you. What type of shit is this? I'm going to be a sued motherfucker, I'm telling you. Well, I got me a bat and I'm using it. They cut my love life out. I can't talk, they ain't scared of nothing. I was watching TV, remember we had scary pictures? How scary pictures do us, man. You'd be so scared, you couldn't go to sleep that night. When your mama said, good night, son, you'd be so scared, mama. Leave the light on. They ain't scared of no light. I got a scary picture the other day. Remember Dawn of the Living Dead when the whole town was dead and everybody was walking around the whole town like this here. And these 5 people locked themselves up in the house. Now, first of all, some people supposed to die. If a whole town is dead, you don't lock yourself up in no house. Use common sense. Common sense ain't common. If I was in a town, the whole town was dead, I would not lock myself in no house. I would open the door and walk out like I want no son of a bitch. And I have my car keys in my goddamn hand. When you do things for a certain reason. I've been married, I've been with my wife 25 years. 25 years of my life. Look at, yeah. Oh, it's fun. See, these are jokes. I wouldn't trade it. I wouldn't trade it for the world. I wouldn't trade my wife for nothing where I ain't saying that for no applause. Cause you learn. Can't fuck no more. Outside pussy is dangerous. Ask Clinton. Everybody say, now he's a dog. He's wrong. Yes, he's wrong. I'm not condoning. You say he fucked her in the White House. What was he gonna take her? Holly Inn? What the president gonna take her to Holly Inn? You fucking the bathroom like the fuck he did. Suck it, suck it, suck it. Who you gonna, you can't talk that to your wife. You can't tell your wife, suck it, bitch, suck it. You get your spaz, suck it, you motherfucker, you. Anytime a woman save a dress with some sperm on, that's how you talk to her. Suck it, you filthy bitch, suck. I ain't gonna lie to you, I love me some oral sex, I ain't gonna lie to you. When a woman do me, man, it just drives me crazy. I can't control myself, I can't. I ain't gonna lie to you. Last time I had oral sex was, man, years ago. Man, that woman was something else. That woman was something else. I'm looking for that heifer right now, you know? Oral sex just make you just do things, just say things. You ever had a woman give you oral sex, man, and look at you? Fuck you looking at me for? Concentrate. Focus. I'm just kidding. Cause see, y'all some sick bastards. Y'all like that nasty shit. Look at you. Say it. People love nasty jokes. I don't know why people like fuck jokes and all that kind of stuff. What's so funny about fuck jokes? What's so funny? See, look at her. Say it. What's so fucking funny about fuck jokes? You need Jesus. You don't need to hear nothing about no goddamn fuck joke. I ain't telling no more goddamn fuck joke. I'm tired of fucking. I'm tired of fucking with you. That's why I tell, man, it's all about love. I tell my family and stuff all the time. See, all this stuff up here, man, it's fun. It's jokes. It got its place. But it don't tell you who you are.
You got to know who the hell you are. And when you know who you are, you know the all you can be. Don't let nobody tell you, man, Bernie Mac, I don't give a fuck about y'all talking about liking me. Fuck y'all. I like me my goddamn self. These is jokes. Jokes! When I get through telling jokes, then I'm the real goddamn man. This is a half an hour of bullshit. That's what I tell my wife, I tell my auntie. My auntie, she's a superficial woman. She like material shit. She worry about what people think and say about her. She treat all the kids real bad, except her little kid, Tyree, with his stuttering half retarded ass, you know. Now, I don't mean no harm. I call like I see it. Cause he ain't retarded, he black, he retarded. He be playing like, ain't nothing wrong with that son of a bitch. That son of a bitch smart as hell, he smart. Anytime he gotta clean up or something, he going to. If you tell him to pick up something, he go right into the. I said, that son of a bitch faking like a son of a bitch. He read when he want to play or something, he just eyes straighten up and everything. He just talk real well and everything, mouth a little crooked. But when you get on him and discipline him, and he stutter real bad. He want to shake his stuttering son of a bitch, you know. And my auntie treat him like he's a prince. She got him so spoiled, y'all. She got the school bus picking this boy up, man. The school right across the street. Ain't that spoiled? Now, when he playing, he walk all regular. He walk just like this when he playing. Now, when she tell him to walk to school, that's something she all doing all this shit here. Hey, ain't nothing wrong with that bastard. He on the corner waiting on the school bus. The school bus pull up. Now, he stutter real bad. He want no shaking stuttering some bitches, you know. School bus open the door. He walk up to the school bus. Bus driver closed the door and drove the fuck off. Next day, same corner. He standing on the corner. School bus pulled up, opened the door. He did it again. Bus driver did like this here. Closed the door and drove the hell out. Oh, he mad now. He went home and told my aunt. She mad now. Nah, we ain't having this shit here. I'm going to school with you in the morning. And I wish that bus driver would drive off. It's gonna be all in the news. She took her time, walked from school the next morning. She put him on the corner. She went in the bushes and hid. She had a video camera and everything. Bus driver pulled up, opened the door. He did it again. He did it again. Bus driver closed the door. Auntie jumped out. Hold on! Black bastard, hold on! What's your goddamn problem? Denying this little boy his education. Bus driver jumped off the bus and said, he was teasing me.
Gentlemen from Chicago, Illinois, Mr. Bernie Mac. Bernie Mac.
begging and shit. I ain't coming back up in here. I swear to God, I ain't. And the Taj Mahal. Look at this raggedy ass. Ought to call this shit the vacant barn. Nigga. A lot of y'all ain't laughing right now, but goddamn it, I'm funny. I'm going to have your ass vomiting in a minute. You just hold on. Because I can tell you right now, you ain't going to sit out here and half-ass laugh at me. I can tell you that right now. I know what the hell I'm doing. Y'all the one bought the ticket. And another adjustment you need to make. The way I talk is just the way I talk. I talk like this all the time. You can quit writing your little letters in to the WB talking about I'm a piss poor example for your kids because I play a teacher on TV and I'm never grammatically correct. I ain't responsible for raising your kids. If your kids ain't shit, that's your fault. Oh, I've been wanting to say this here for a long time. And I know I got about 4 or 5 letters from Atlantic City too. I hope your ass is sitting out here this evening. Cause this is just the way I talk. I talk like this on the Steve Harvey Show. I talk like this on Showtime and Apollo. I like talking just like this him. Cause the shit feel good to me. That's how I'm looking around the room. It's a nice mix of people in here. I don't care what color you are. Long as your ass paid the money to get in here and I get mine, that's all I'm concerned with. Because I swear to God, you better hope to God I get mine. Don't let me not get mine. This would be your last show at the raggedy ass Taj Mahal. I swear to God about that. I'll burn this motherfucker down. I'll go around this something. I was shocking a lot of y'all. A lot of y'all just see me on TV. Y'all don't get to see the real version. This is the real deal. So you get them surprise-ass looks off your face right now. We're going to have a good-ass time. You done bought these high-ass tickets. Might as well have a good-ass time. You won yours on the radio. Might have asked you shit. Everybody else can come out here and do their act without your country ass jumping in. I'm gonna tell you right now, I ain't the one, son of a bitch. You should have tried that with Guy or somebody when they ass was out here. Look, let me explain something to y'all. I host Showtime at the Apollo every Saturday night. I'm with the most ignorant people in the world every Saturday night. Be damned if I come down here to raggedy ass Atlantic City and be scared of one of y'all, this raggedy ass. Oh, crazy po-ass town. Ought to be glad we came to this raggedy-ass place. Trump Tower. Donald ought to be ashamed of his damn self. Ain't putting no money back into it. Just taking your money out of that casino. Ain't putting, look at this raggedy-ass stage and all this shit. He Donald Trump. Yeah, I better cool out. I know he got friends and shit. I better. Y'all kill a person in Atlantic City, you'd never see their ass again. A lot of language you hear tonight will be a little bit different. There's cultural differences in people. You have to come to accept that. That ain't a racist remark. That's just the truth. They got a thing out called Ebonics. I never got with the term Ebonics. This is just the way I talk. You ain't never had no label on it before. I have a certain flavor when I talk. I get my flavor from the way I talk from old black people. I don't know if you've been around them before. Most of y'all have. For those of you that ain't, this going to be a cultural shock for your ass this evening. Old black people are the ones who can really set you straight on how language is supposed to go. Because the beauty of old black people take whole sentences and jam them down into just one long ass word. You don't ever know what they said, you just know what they meant. You ever had old black people say something to you, you ain't know what they said, you just know what they meant? Yeah, a lot of y'all don't play like you don't know what I'm talking about, but I got a list of words for you. You ever heard somebody say something to you like, "Hey, sit down there, right there down there." I said, "Sit down there, right there down there." Now, you don't know what they said, but you know you need to put something the fuck down. Sit that there, right there, down there. See, now a lot of y'all gonna have trouble staying with me on this because you got some little punk ass job downtown and you think your ass done made it now. But this is a reality check when I hit the stage, so I'm gonna make your ass be real whether you wanna be or not. There are a list of words that we use that are true to us that a lot of people ain't familiar with. I will show you, a lot of you are country, but you think because you in Atlantic City that your ass ain't no more. But you really are, because you ain't forgot how you really are. See, when you ain't on your job, you at home, and you talk a little bit different. Here's some words that you've all said 1,000 times, and if you ain't said them 1,000 times, you done heard them 1,000 times. Here's a word everybody in here done said, and you don't even realize it. The word is Afrin-tween. Don't be looking around like your ass ain't heard it. What? The word is Afrin-tween. See, you, it sounds German, don't it? Afrin-tween. But you done all said it, and if you ain't said it, you done heard it. Afrin-tween. I heard it today, driving around in one of these little crazy-ass neighborhoods, heard some old lady talking to a little kid out in the street and used the word Afrin-tween in a sentence. Y'all cheerers, get in here. Get y'all's ass out that street. Come on in here now. Get out between them cars. What the hell is Afrin-tween? Get Afrin-tween them cars. I damn near die. A lot of y'all ain't laughing. I'm telling you, this shit is real. I'm gonna make you come along anyway. I ain't through. I got another one for you. Here's another one. Here's another word everybody in here done use and you ain't even know it. I'm gonna spell this one. One word, 4 letters, all capital. Capital E, N, N, O. E, N, N, O. See there, you ain't eating no. You ain't eating no. You ain't eating no. She didn't know, he didn't know, they ain't eating no. I don't know how they ain't know that. Everybody know that. He ain't even know that. Stupid son of a bitch, he ain't even know that. All right, this is the last one, because I see a lot of y'all can't handle this right here. Some of y'all can't even laugh at the joke. This is the last one. I'm going to spell this one, too. This is a speller. This is another speller. Okay, I can see that the spelling is taking some of y'all out to joke. Education ain't what it's supposed to be. Thought you was cute when you dropped out, didn't you? If you can't read that good, I ain't really cracking or nothing, because when I was coming up as a kid, I couldn't read that good myself. I was struggling. You remember when you was in school and and teacher had that little reading group, and everybody in the class used to have to bring their chair up front and make a little circle, and everybody had to read a paragraph, but your ass couldn't read that good, so you tried to count the kids in front of you so you could get a jump on your paragraph? Oh Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord, here they come. Come on, Lord. Work with me, Father. Oh, Lord, Jesus, you see them coming. Say, man, what's that word right there? Dog? Okay, appreciate that, player. Thanks a lot. Oh, Lord. Say, man, what's that word right there? Come on. Come on. Don't fuck with me. What's the word? So this is the last one I'm going to spell. Listen, I see y'all. I'm losing y'all. Y'all look tight right now. This is the last one I'm going to spell. Here's a word everybody can use. One word, 3 parts. First part, C-U-M, C-U-M, come. T-A-W, tall. B-O-U-T, bout. Come talk about. He come talking about he gonna leave me.
Yeah, that's funny. Y'all kiss my ass.
I like language because it means something to me. You got them people in your family that's old and still can't pronounce words, then got older, ain't been around, nobody know how to pronounce nothing correct. You got them people in your family? Do you have them people in your family? Hey, look, I know y'all hear me. Don't play with me like this, goddammit. Comedy is a two-way street. I tell the jokes, your ass provides the laughs. And I'm out here asking y'all questions. Y'all looking around like y'all busy. Y'all got some more shit to do. You better get with these jokes. I'm telling you, ain't no refunds in here. If you think this shit gonna pick up, goddammit, this it. You know, I'm gonna start tearing into some of y'all's ass, because if you think I'm gonna crash and burn by myself, you're just wrong. I care everybody in here with my ass. I swear to God, you can ask God about me. I will carry your ass with me. Now, you got people in your family That's right. These are the same people that the media has a knack for locating every time a newsworthy event go down in our community. They find a way to locate this ignorant ass bastard and ask him what the hell went on. That's what irritates me about the media. We have thousands of articulate people in our neighborhood that can describe anything articulately as anybody else. But no, no, they go find his ass. And you can spot him too, because soon as they show his ass, you be sitting there going, God damn. This motherfucker finna set us back 200 years. Because you know it's him. He got a plastic bag on his head, pack of Kools rolled up in his t-shirt, got some house shoes on, big ass glass of Kool-Aid, standing in front of his mama's house. It just burns you up. And I'm watching you. This just happened this week, because you know, you heard about the hurricane that was down in Florida. Hurricane George was coming through there. They had told everybody in Florida to evacuate. Now you know, evacuate is too big a word for some of the ignorant ass people that we know. And sure enough, they showed this family, this brother and his family was packing up. And soon as the camera swung over and showed the brother packing up, I just went, oh, hell no. Because that was him right there. And I knew that this was going to be the interview to really fuck us over as a people. And sure enough, here the little white reporter come. They just know how to find it. They'll look past all the neighborhood and they'll spot his ass. And here he came up just saying, sir, sir, I see you in the process of evacuating. We ain't got time for that shit. We got to get the fuck out of here. And then the little reporter just kept on, but sir, sir, that's what you're doing. You're in the process of evacuating. I'm telling you, man, we got to go. We ain't got time to vacuum this motherfucker. And it don't ever stop there. All you got to do is watch television to understand the two-faced country that we live in. America's two-faced. Do you understand that? America will build something up, make it number one, and soon as it's number one, they'll tear it down. Prime example, the Jerry Springer Show. They done made that show number one, now everybody want it off the air all of a sudden because it's politically incorrect. I don't know what the damn uproar is about. Me personally, I like the Jerry Springer Show. I ain't lying, goddammit, I get mad if I miss an episode. Because you know why? Because the Jerry Springer Show is a reality check for me. It is the one show on all of television that lets me know that I'm A, the fuck okay. Oh, I got some shit going wrong in my life, but trust me, it ain't nowhere near that fucked up. Oh, I got some crazy ass family members too, but I bet you all the money I got, my brother ain't sleeping with my daddy. Boy, this shit be on TV, and I'm gonna tell you something. See, the thing I like about the Springer Show is you can enjoy the Jerry Springer Show, because you know what's gonna happen. You know in any given minute, somebody gonna come around that corner that's gonna turn this motherfucker out. You know just the right one gonna come around there and the show gonna get really good. And then the other thing, you can understand the Springer Show. You can't enjoy and understand every show. Shit, like Jeopardy. You ever watch Jeopardy? I was sitting at the house watching Jeopardy one day. God damn, I'm stupid than a motherfucker. Yeah, I'm doing pretty good, making a little money now and everything, but technically, I don't know a goddamn thing. Them categories be all out the pocket. Aerodynamics for 400. I don't know what aerodynamics is for $1.25. And here was burning me up about everybody. Now, America make me sick. Now you know what they're trying to say? That all the fights on the Springer Show is fixed. Y'all, look at him. I'm from the projects. I know an ass whooping when I see one. Them is real ass whoopings, y'all. Trust me, them is real ass whoopings. There ain't nothing fake about your dress coming all up over your head and your drawers done rolled up in the crack of your ass. God damn it, that's real. When your drawers is in the crack of your ass, that's real. Cause I don't care how mad you get, you want them drawers out your ass. Oh, you could be fighting like you ain't ever fought before. Motherfucker, go. Motherfucker, get on that. Hey, hey, come on, hold on now. Here, the only thing I don't really get about the Springer Show. You know the dudes that break up the fights? The ball, Steve Nim. I see your ass ain't familiar with the term Nim. Steve Nim. Nim covers all. That's Steve and every motherfucking body he know. You're gonna sit out here and question my grammar again. Nim? Y'all killing me acting like y'all's ass is that bougie. Steve Nim. That break up the fights, you know what trips me out about? They don't ever get swung on. How can that be? You ever seen anybody turn and swing on them? That's the only thing I question. Because let me tell you something. You got some people in your family. You know that when their ass is mad, I mean really mad, you can't touch their ass. I got some family members a tie this motherfucker up if you touch them when their ass is mad. Be arguing on TV. Hey, man, I'm telling you, no. That's bullshit. You don't come over. Man, no. Hey, motherfucker. You better go on now and mess around and get your ass whooped. Shit, my wife done brought me out here on national TV talking about she passing out ass while I'm at work. I kill everybody in this motherfucker. And I see you got an extra chair out here too. You bring another motherfucker out here. I'm gonna kick your ass, Jerry. And the thing I love most about Jerry, you know what really does me? When white folks is on the show. Oh, it just warms my heart over. When we finally get to see that they ass is just as crazy as our ass. Oh, when they got them trailer park living some bitches on now. Oh, them motherfuckers is off the hook. Boy, them motherfucking trailer park people got some shit going on, ain't going on nowhere else. Boy, they had a whole family out there. Grandmama screwing the baby girl. The aunt slept with the daddy. The daddy sleeping with his son. Grandmama sleeping with the babysitter. The babysitter doing the dog in the closet. Just, boy, they had some crazy shit going on. I sit there and just lights my ass up. I cut the volume up high. I don't want to miss shit. But the trouble with them, they can't fight. White folks disappoint me when they fight. They just, what's wrong? Just telegraph your blows. Be coming from all backstage. Just. Motherfucker, we see you. You ain't sneaking up on nobody. You got to get black people out there to see how to really get a fight going. One of them broke up. See, black people try to sneak your ass. They try to let you think ain't nothing wrong, you know. They bring him out, and now here's Willie. Why goddamn Willie come backstage? Willie be speaking to people on the way out? Motherfucker, let go. Let me go, let me go, let me go. Motherfucker, let me go. See, I stay focused with America because I watch TV. I don't never trip. That's why I just, as a minority in this country, I ain't never thrown off. I don't let the stats fool me. We the leading cause of welfare. All this bullshit. Cut on the TV and pay attention. It ain't just us. If you're watching the news lately, white folks is losing their mind. White people are tripping. Been hearing about all them shootings up at the school? Them white kids, them little crazy ass white kids done went in there and shot everybody at the goddamn school. You ain't never seen a black boy or girl go in there and shoot everybody at the school. You know why? Because we respect the educational system. Even though we ain't learning shit in there, we ain't gonna deny your ass an education. We'll shoot your ass in the parking lot. Oh, out in back of the grocery store. Better not catch your ass.